We're grilling myconids for this week's crit sandwich. On Crit Sandwich, four friends play 5th edition D&D campaigns loosely based on our favorite movies, TV shows, and video games. For this campaign, our characters are royalty in the Underdark, playing the plot of Die Hard. I am Casey Sears. To my left is Chuck Ventus.
Howdy-ho.
Across the table from me, Sir Robert Ponder.
Hello.
To my right, Popich, our dungeon master.
I feel like I should be walking up to the Reds, take a bat. That's what they sound like on the Reds at the Red Stadium. Ah. I should have my theme music playing. They do that too. Anyway,
what would your theme song be?
A Metallica song of some sort. No, not that one. Probably Enter Sandman. It's not my favorite song by theirs, but I feel like it would get me pumped up. That doom, 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 doom. You know, get me fired up to hit a ball real hard.
So. You don't want to be Hero of the Day.
I love Hero of the Day. They've got a lot of great songs, but I just feel like that one would get me fired up to really smack the shit out of a ball. So, hey guys, how's everybody doing?
Good.
Glad to hear it. This is going to be episode 2. Episode 1 saw one of you kill your mage and mother.
Mm-hmm.
No, it wasn't killing her.
No, that's kind of your goal, though.
It wasn't like if you push a button, you're like, it's not like a button that releases a guillotine. It was a button that
it was close enough.
It was a button that really trapped her.
She could have held her own.
It was a button that trapped her down in a ballroom with our enemies, and they slaughtered her.
Yeah.
No, she's a very strong and powerful lady.
I was waiting for you to kill her. I just didn't think it'd be today.
That was very quick.
And yet here it is. Mm-hmm. Yeah, your house was attacked, and the three of you are up in the very attic in the panic room. I mean, at this point, you feel not great, but semi-safe at least. I mean, it seems as though magic that can look inside of there or outside, or like, magic can't penetrate the wall that's around you. So that's at least in your minds making you feel okay about the fact that, hey, all you got to do is survive the night and, you know, that this family will be punished and you'll be okay or whatever, you know, is going on down there. So at this point, you feel pretty good that, it, you know, well, probably your matron mother's dead. At least you're in a room that should let you survive. I think we'll start this session. I gave you guys each one blue and two green magic items. Just whatever you want to say about those, I guess, is what I want to hear. And then we'll actually get to playing. Casey, can we start with you?
Sure. My first green are the winged boots, which lets me fly around up to 4 hours a day. Each time I use at least a minute each time. I have the rapier of warning, which is a fancy sword that gets real loud if someone's going to try to kill us or attack us. And my blue item is the wand of viscid glob. That I point at someone and it launches a little booger at them. And if that little booger hits them, it turns into a big old booger. And then they are frozen and encased in a giant, giant, hard as rock booger.
Sucky.
Yeah. And it looks like a little spider. It's like a little spider with its little butt bent over.
Sure.
And then they come out of the spider's butt.
Love it.
Nice.
Yep.
Thanks for saying it in character voice.
Yeah.
You're welcome.
Ish. Chuck.
My stuff is not nearly that exciting. My blue item is literally just a +2 short sword.
All right.
So, I mean, I wanted a good weapon. I'm good with the weapons, inspecting them. I have a cloak of protection. You know, it's my keep me safe, I guess, from all the punishment I've endured from my family. You know, I need to have somewhat of an AC to have lived this long. And then my other green item is gloves of thievery. These gloves are invisible while worn, but while wearing them, I gain +5 bonus to dexterity sleight of hand checks and dexterity checks made to pick locks.
Nice.
Very nice. So. And Robbie?
Yes, I have a rod of the pack keeper, a wand of magic missiles, which lets me cast magic missile at a 7th level spell slot.
Ooh.
Or any really level spell slot, and it has 7 charges. And each charge you use is like an extra spell slot. And then I have a Medallion of Thoughts. And the Medallion of Thoughts I actually got while I was in my trial to become a High Priestess.
Nice. What does that do?
So the Medallion of Thoughts, while wearing it, you can use an action to expend one of the charges. It has 3 charges, and it lets me cast Detect Thoughts.
Cool.
Can I ask a question? So our sister Lotria. Mm-hmm. She was trying to become a high priestess.
Yes.
Is Aunt Tarla a high priestess? Like, yes. Who are the high... So any female that's high up is a high priestess, basically? Or?
No, you have to go through the trial.
Okay, so you have to go through a trial.
Yeah, so the more your family has, the stronger your family is. So I would say to be a top 8 family, you need at least 3, which your family has in Matron plus our 2 players. And then you were going for a 4th.
Well, we probably... We just have 2 now, because...
Yeah, you definitely...
10 killed our mother.
Correct. Right.
Or killed mother.
Yeah, so. Our family is fucked.
Yeah, like, we're pretty screwed after right this. Now.
Like, so even if you, even if you survive, like, you'll keep all your house and your everything, but you'll be weaker as a family. Like this opened you up to other houses taking a look at you now as far as.
We're vulnerable.
You basically. Are. So definitely, potentially part of the mystery here is, like, how were they able to, A, know this was a good day to attack you, and B, how were they able to get, even then, they shouldn't have been able to get past the guards. So that certainly is something that could be found out if you play your cards right. We'll see.
Yep.
We need to work as a team.
That's the funniest thing you've ever said.
Wow.
It is. You kill
our
you.
I need you guys to help me make up for my mistake.
No, I would never say I made any mistakes.
Oh, so was it intentional? That's what you're saying.
I don't think your character would care about it.
This is out of character.
Yeah, let's get in character. Let's get in character, because I do think these are things that should be addressed in character. All right, so you guys are locked in an attic, basically. It doesn't feel like dusty and dingy attic. You're surrounded by metal on all sides, and it is an enchanted metal of some sort that doesn't allow any sort of see-throughness or anything like that. No divination is getting in or out of it. Again, the room adorned with a really like low dim light that is coming from things hanging from the ceiling, little like chandelier basically, with infinite light shedding like a just like a light purpley all around you. There's the main feature of the room is this statue that is of a huge spider, and then like a little seat in front of it where you can see that basically this is where Matron Baenre would come and pray to Lolth. And then behind it is just a huge, gigantic vault of doesn't seem like you're able to enter at this point. Below you, you at this point don't know what's down there, but you believe is a bunch of slaves, a bunch of attacking house family members, as well as what you think is a dead matron mother. Let's kick it off right there. What's going on? What are your guys' thoughts as you are trapped in this room?
I would probably walk off to a corner and just kind of say, oh, man, Zajiri, we're pretty fucked now, man. Yeah, bloodshed will be spread tonight. It's going to be one hell of a ride.
You should be down there with your soldiers, getting the fine end of a sword being pierced through your heart right now.
Yes, I agree. You know, I was kind of surprised when Mother let me come up the ladder before her, but, you know, you're right, I should be down there.
She made a grave mistake. I don't know why her ego had to get in the way and not let me carry her up. Well, she was growing old and she was growing weak. We knew this day would come. Are you ready for it, Ten? Are you ready for the responsibilities?
We don't need to jump there yet. We don't know if she's dead or not. It was odd that she brought Ildan up here with us. Do not need a man protecting me.
Yeah, that's fine. You do all the work yourself. But what was more surprising was when you pressed the button to kill Mother.
There was not a button to kill her. It was a button to save our lives and to save our family name.
Yeah. You know, if you don't hit him, I will. Like, he should not be speaking please. To you like that.
Yes, yes. Hit me, yeah. Come on, hit me.
Hit me.
Do it. I start smacking myself.
Wait, I gotta...
In the face. Come on. Fuck you! Ah!
I gotta look up the spelled name. Give me a second. Gosh.
That was good, Chuck.
I use inspiration to smack myself as hard as...
Roll the hit. I feel like smacking him is beneath me, like someone else should be doing it for me, like another female that's not you or I, Casey. So I will cast Infestation on him. You cause a cloud of mites, fleas, and other things to appear momentarily on one creature you can see within range. The target must succeed on Constitution saving throw or take 1d6 poison damage. And you also, go ahead and like see if you fail or pass. We'll see.
I roll 13.
You fail. So you move randomly in a certain direction.
What?
You move randomly in a certain direction. You can't control yourself.
As bugs are crawling all over your body.
Right.
Oh, fuck. It's like being in my bed. It's awesome.
Oh, what?
Bed bugs.
Not that it matters, but you move 5 feet to the east uncontrollably.
What? How much damage do I take?
1d6.
Ooh, I rolled high. Sorry.
I don't think you add anything to that. It's just...
Okay. 5 damage.
All right. So some bickering amongst the ranks here.
I'm so sorry. It's actually a 2d6. I cast it at since I'm...
Was this a spell slot or was this a
cantrip? This is a cantrip.
All right, good. I was like, damn.
So 10 damage. Oof, on a cantrip.
Damn. At least it wasn't a Eldritch Blast, I guess.
Maybe you'll learn your place now.
So I just moved to the east just for...
Yeah, you're like scratching.
I was like, oh, it's weird. Fuck. I kind of like it. Maybe hit me with something harder next time.
I kind of roll my eyes and I want to... Like, move on beyond this. Like, we need to discuss our future plan now. What do we have in line for ourselves? We need to make it through the night. We need to discover what the family name is that is attacking us.
Well, matron mother, you're in charge. Why don't you decide?
Oh, yeah, fuck. A little sass on it. I love it.
Yeah. Guess that kill worked for you.
As I itch my balls, I say, hey, over there, I was looking at that statue. Like I said before, something ain't right with it. Maybe you could look at it.
We seem safe in this room, but at some point we're going to have to leave, and I don't even know how to start doing that.
We also need to discover the family's name that is attacking us before the end of the night.
I'll get to the ground and just put my ear to the floor and see if I hear anything with my drow ears.
Give me a perception roll.
26.
Woo!
So you hear no voices or anything downstairs now, other than one person says, and when Alexander saw the breadth of his domain, he wept, for there were no more worlds to conquer. That's from my diehard.
Yes.
I repeat that to my niece and nephew, ask them if that means anything to them.
Can I do like a history check? Maybe I know someone named Alexander in another family?
Go for it.
9.
Right, that didn't mean anything to me, right?
You can do a history check just like he did.
Okay.
Should I do a history check as well, I guess?
He relayed it to you guys?
He asked us if that meant anything to us, so.
15 for Casey.
5 for Ildan.
That is a common saying amongst a, at this point, much lower level house, the Omabas. They used to be, a long time ago, one of the most powerful houses. They were actually the top house. But they were wiped out long ago. They were like, they're not even a house at this point.
How would you spell that?
O-M-A-B-A. There's some apostrophes in there, but...
The Obamas?
Yeah, I was about to say O-M. Obama. God!
Omavas?
The Obamas, the Baracks.
Is the leader, yeah, is their leader, is the matron Barack?
We don't know.
Omava?
Omava, guys, that's way different.
Omava, Bahama, Obama.
Omava.
I've never heard of that before. I'm like finishing up scratching, I guess.
Yeah, so I'll share that. Like, I think that might be the Omabas.
The Omabas family, you said were wiped out though ago, because you rolled high on your history, not me.
Yeah, I'm not sure. I'm not sure how I'd follow up with that. You're like, yeah, as far as I was aware.
Yeah.
Sure. Do you guys want to do anything else?
Nobody's doing anything, so I'm going to look at that statue further.
Yeah,
and see if I can move it or something, you know. Because this room, there's got to be another way out. I got to believe that the matron was smart enough to have, like, an escape route to get out of here or something.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know.
Sure.
Or something up here. You know, I'm going to look in there. I want to look in the safe. You know, I'll say, like, hey, there's probably some really good items in there. You know, we could probably use it to fuck up this family that fucked us up.
I agree. And I don't think the matron mother was smart enough to do that. Maybe like
you don't think
a
mother was smart
of her.
Enough?
Our matron mother wasn't smart enough to have another escape out of here. Maybe a matron beyond her. I'm saying that as Robbie. I wouldn't say it out loud.
Mm. I hear your thoughts.
Sure. Just letting you know, the matron that was killed was not very wise.
So if there's anything on this statue that I can like pull or mess with, like, I'm going to do it.
Okay, do an investigation.
A six.
Seems to be a really solid, spidery statue. It's made out of pretty, like, really high-level granite and marble and stuff like that.
While he's over there and he's messing with it, I will shove him away once he's done. And I will be like, the statue is not for messing with. It is for prayer. And right now, if we need anybody, we need Loth. We need Loth on our side. And I will actually get onto the rug and kneel down.
Hmm.
I will start a prayer. And I will say, Loth, I know you won't give more than you can bear. I know that you are in control. And I know that our family was in your favor. May we persevere. May you do this for a reason. May all of this happen for a reason. And I will pray to Loth and just be kind of like, hey, this is our family. This is clearly happening for a reason. You wanted this to happen. You brought us into the top eight for a reason. You know, just say a prayer and a blessing upon the three of us so that we may conquer this other family.
Sure. I do a slow clap for Aunt Tarla after that prayer.
Go ahead and clap it. There it is.
Hell yeah.
And Aunt Tarla, give me a wisdom saving throw. What's the other one?
Check.
I was like, nothing bad is happening.
I just rolled a one.
Yeah, you did.
So that's a four.
Can't help you.
So is that...
Your prayer falls on deaf ears. Like, just...
Oh, no.
Yeah. And in fact, you get the sense that things like this only happen to families that, like, Loth is out of favor.
Yeah, yeah. When you said that prayer and you said our family was in Loth's favor, I would have you wouldn't have seen it, but I would have shaken my head no. But I appreciate your prayer anyways, and after you were done praying, I would have said, well said. And I would be walking around the room and investigating everything in the room that's around here, because I've never been up here before.
So you two, what happened to this family while I was gone? I did not feel anything just praying to Loth. Are we no longer in her favor?
I felt that our family...
I sounded like Mr. Smith from Matrix there.
I feel that our family hasn't been in Loth's favor for a while, even before you left to the surface.
I ensured this family made it to the top eight with all of the slaves I brought, all of the soldiers I provided.
As was I, fighting on the front lines while you were away when there was families that attacked us.
Which, families haven't attacked us for a while, but...
Yeah, it's been a long time since you've been a target, for sure.
I have just one job here, weapons master, train the troops, inspect the weapons.
Well, I hope your troops deliver.
Doesn't sound like it.
So you guys have been up here for a bit now without, unfortunately, much progress that I was hoping one of you would roll well. which has been poor. At this point, you're going to start to hear below you, like, there's not such a thing as a drill, but like whatever a magical drill would be, and you start to feel the ground beneath you start to get hot as it, like, in a certain area. It's like the floor is vibrating and it's getting hotter.
I want to try and pick the safe or whatever it is.
Just try to open it first.
I want to try and use it. I suspect that there are traps. I'm going to use some lock picking tools.
Yeah, do an investigation check first.
Okay. 9.
You sense no traps whatsoever. That's the luck, motherfucker.
I'm going to... Hey, should I open this?
I want to look at it for him, too.
Hey, why don't you do that Sword of Omen thing?
What?
Well, you can see through shit, right?
If you're picking the lock, it's not worth me casting it for you. I'll investigate for him. 13.
Looks fine to you.
I glance at it up and down, and then I walk away and don't say anything to Ildan. Ildan keeps talking about the statue. While he is distracted, I pretend to care about... Well, I don't... I care about what he says, but I'm not going to let him know I care about what he says. So I'm going to go check out the statue when he's screwing around with this vault door.
Give me an investigation check.
Yeah, baby. 21.
So you give this spider a careful look over and see that it's... fangs, the two front fangs, are protruding a little bit. You feel like if you grabbed both of them at the same time and pulled them down, kind of like an udder, you would... It seems like something would happen. Chuck, do you want to do anything with
Vault? Okay, nobody's going to stop me. I'm going to fucking open this. I'm going to open it.
Okay. Mm. Yeah, so the moment you touch it, you trigger what's called a glyph of warding.
It's fine. I'm used to taking damage.
Oh, man.
Oh, shit. So this is actually in a 20-foot radius. There's an explosion of magical energy.
Are we all in that radius?
Tell me where... So Robbie is, if he's looking at the statue, for sure.
Last time I was anywhere, I was standing kind of close to that statue.
You were?
Yeah.
Oh, fuck. Well, against all you guys. Jesus. I need dexterity saving throws from each of you.
7 for Casey.
Oof. Talena got a 3.
Guys, this is the most self-destructive party I've ever...
28. I'm fine. I rolled a 19.
Oh, man, you were so
9.
Close to that.
So I guess you saw it.
So, and actually, wow. I have evasion. When you are subject to an effect that allows you to make a dex saving throw to take only half damage, you instead take no damage if you succeed on a saving throw, and only half if I fail.
So that'll be 18 damage for the two ladies, half as much, and half of that. Apparently.
I don't think I take. Did I pass?
You passed.
So I don't take any, right?
All right. Well, basically, you triggered a ward, saw that it was about to explode, booked it, and then you're too...
I got hit in the back.
Yeah, neither of you guys saw it coming and took 18 damage.
I tumble and said, before you were messing with that, I could have dispelled the magic, you idiot.
Holy
and I grab like the nearest like vase or something next to me and chuck it at him.
make an attack roll.
That was a 1.
So it just goes horribly wide. Like,
oh, you should make it hit me.
like he wonders even if you were throwing it at him. So, but yeah. Or were you just like angrily throwing it against a wall? Nobody knows.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, people can't tell if I was just throwing it to throw it or to throw it at him.
Yep.
Holy shit! That was fucking nuts, right? Man, I kind of wish I got burnt a little bit.
Well, at least that glyph is gone.
Yeah.
Perhaps your slippery little fingers will get it this time.
Oh, I will tell Ildan, I will say, hey, come over here and pull on these fangs.
Sure. I'll milk this for you, I guess.
Milk it. I want to watch you do it. Pull on those fangs.
You have to do it alternatively, one at a time.
Yeah. Like this, you know? I do a jerk off.
I don't want to watch a visual. Thank you, Chuck.
All right. I go and pull on the fangs.
So... Above you, to the upper left, a panel slides out, and you can see an air vent where air comes into the room.
Fuck me, look at that. She fucking had a way out.
You know, guys, I thought we were bad at D&D for a minute, but I think we're good. I think we're very good at this game.
You're taking more damage than I thought you would early on. I'm going to say that much, but...
I didn't take any damage except for my family, so I think this is perfectly in line with my character.
Well,
should we check out that magical item safe now that the that explosion happened?
So the floor is vibrating and hot.
Yes. It's increasingly so, but it started. Give me a perception check.
That's something I am good at.
Yeah.
13.
You feel like it'll be a while before they can get in.
Okay. Well, it seems like it's going to take them a while. If you want to check out that vault, you can. But also, I am so concerned. I am so concerned that... If you open it, then they will have access to it.
Well, I figured we just take whatever's inside, right? I mean, 10 killed mother, so she's not going to have any use for it.
You shall refer to Talena as matron mother from here on out.
You're right, Antarla. I'm sorry. The new matron mother that killed the old matron mother has no other use for it. Maybe the new matron mother has use for it. I'll cut myself with my one of my daggers.
Talena will give a nod of approval to Tarla. Yeah, you know, like, thank you for kind of a way of saying thank you for enforcing him to call me matron. Talena will say to Tarla,
the former matron was always open to suggestions, and I am open to suggestions too, Tarla, about what to do with the vault. You are correct that the vault items can fall into the enemy's hands, or they could help with our survival. I am not aware that this vault was even here, but it could have things from our ancestors in the vault.
Ildan, you have 2 minutes.
Do I take a damage every time I say I cut myself? I did.
Yeah, one damage.
Okay,
just one.
I applied it.
Okay, good. Thank you.
It's very important.
Yes, agreed.
Do I get the sense that there's no more magic on this thing now that that glyph of warding?
Give me more investigation.
Hey, I'm about to do this again. You think it's okay?
Can I, like, make an arcana check to see if there's something there?
Yeah.
Before he blows himself up.
Well, the rest of you, more likely, it seems like.
Yeah, it was only a 7.
Yeah, you don't get much of a sense of one way or the other.
I rolled a 2 minus 1. That's a 1.
So
I'm about to do this again. Maybe take a step back, yeah?
Yeah. probably a good move.
Yeah, taking cover.
All right. So do you just try to open it, or what do you try to do?
I'd like to disarm the trap.
Okay.
If I can.
So a glyph of warding.
Oh. So I have dispel magic.
Mm.
So I could just, so what is a glyph of warding? Would I know a glyph of warding just comes back, or would I know it goes away?
So there are ways to have it recharge, basically, but they typically take about an hour. You would probably know that.
Okay. So I think he should be safe to crack the vault.
In your estimation from the prior arcane account, yes. A check, yes.
Okay. Yeah, go for it as I hide.
Are you hiding?
I would, Robbie? I will gracefully levitate to the other side of the room as I investigate the walls.
Rolled a 20, I crit.
So you do not see any other traps or anything magical or not magical at this point.
All right.
I thought that was the one to open it. I was like, it's definitely open with a crit.
I want to open it.
Yeah, give it a shot. Give me strength. This is strength because it's so. It's
I
like
rolled
a big,
20.
Wow.
I rolled a fucking 20.
All right. So you pull with all your might around with the it's a huge gigantic lever that looks like an X. You know what I mean? Like that type of big vault. It just doesn't budge at all.
Ooh, with a crit, man. Ooh.
Yeah, you're thinking there's some sort of matron specific type of incantation necessary.
I don't think brute force is what we need for this. It's something else. Hey, sister, maybe you should give it a try, huh? You're the new matron. Maybe it has that weird magic thing, you know? It senses it, since the other one's dead from...
I will levitate to the door, and as I go past Ildan, my nails will start to grow out, and I won't cut him, but I will, grace my nails across his back, as in a gentle scratch across his back of approval for unlocking this door. And I will put my hands on the... Is there a turn handle or something?
There is.
I will try to turn it.
Give me a wisdom check.
22.
So you get the sense that this is kind of like a living door. Like it can kind of... It's not animated completely, but it has a sense of it, of talking, and it does talk to the matron. However, you can't actually talk back to it without the proper talisman.
Can I try speaking it to it telepathically?
Go for it.
I will say to the door, I'm like, I am the matron now. I command you to open. I close my eyes and I tilt my head forward and I say that telepathically to the door.
Give me another wisdom check.
19.
You get the sense that the door can hear you, but you're just not speaking the same language, basically. And again, you think that's related to whoever holds the talisman.
Okay. So as long as a creature can speak one language, we can understand each other.
More like the talisman lets you speak the language that it speaks.
Okay.
Hey, guess what? I'm fast forwarding through the story. Whoever's downstairs has the talisman, and they're digging through this floor, and they're going to fucking get whatever's in here, so let's move.
Yeah, so you said the door can understand me,
yes,
but I can't understand the door. So I will still say the door telepathically that I am the matron now. And the talisman, I will get the talisman back, but there may be someone that comes here. There may be another imposter with the talisman and not a matron of House Baenre. And then I will turn to the party and I will say, I think it's time for us to go into the air vent. We need a talisman to open this door. And the talisman is on the body of the former matron.
Any potions or anything in this room that we could snag before we leave?
There is a little apothecary area, it looks like, where there's some mixins in there. You can go ahead, give me a medicine check. You can see what you can glean from it.
I just wrote another 20.
Wow, that's 3.
My God. Wow.
Minus one. Wow. So 19, I guess, but...
Okay. So there, yeah, you're crushing it. So, yeah, it makes this a little... So there's a whole bunch of reagents to, like, make things here. Again, it's just, like, a little table off to the side with a whole bunch of, you know, toads, eyeballs, and, you know, that kind of shit. That's a really good roll. I'll go ahead and say that it held on it a poison that you can, like, apply to your weapons if you want to. So there's a poison. You can find it in D&D Beyond. It's going to have three applications, and you can add it to your weapon and do poison damage. And then there's also two potions of healing.
I'll take the poison. I guess I'll just throw it into my little pouch on my belt area and just try and stuff them in there real quick. I don't tell anybody. I just take it.
Were you guys looking at him? Do we want to do a sleight of hand check, or do you care?
I don't think I'd care.
I'm not looking at him.
Okay.
Oh, my sleight of hand's really good, guys. It's plus 17.
Jesus. we'll just assume you crushed it.
Plus 17, that's pretty good.
Yeah.
I'll actually say one of the potions I will chug just to get my health back up to full.
Okay. Even though you're the one that didn't even get hurt by the blast.
I got hurt by... actually, you know what? I'm going to keep the poison or keep the potions. I'm not going to chug it. You're right.
Well, don't let me convince you. I just thought it was funny.
Yeah, it's fine.
All right.
They got healing spells.
All right. So Matron Mother said get in the vent. So I'm hopping my wide butt into that vent.
Yeah. I got to believe that's a sight. Aren't you like super old?
Yeah. Yes. I'm even older than the Matron Mother herself and all of the time on the surface with all of my, well, A, being in direct sunlight, and B, also like all of the magic I use to disguise myself and look like other people has really taken its toll on me.
Hmm.
I will nod at Ildan to go. I don't want him...
Behind you?
I don't want him behind me looking at my butt, so he can go next.
Well, you're in the same... You're his sister, but all right.
Trust me, there's not much to look at.
I don't think
I
that...
jump up there.
That doesn't matter in Drow.
It's Hank Hill back here.
Does anyone have a lighter for some light as we crawl through this air vent?
For Drow, we can see 120 feet ahead of us in the dark.
It's a movie thing.
Oh.
So you guys go up into the air vent, leaving the area, again, still vibrating and getting hot below you.
I would do my mage hand as we leave, and I will cover our tracks as we go. I will make sure the vent is closed, do mage hand on those fangs, and get rid of any evidence of anything that we have touched. And what Ildan, when he crit to the safe, I'll make sure that the safe is locked again. And I will make it look like we weren't here and definitely cover our tracks as we go into the vent.
Perfect.
Oh, and the hot spot,
mm-hmm.
Before I jump in there, I would actually love to cast Glyph of Warding on the hot spot.
Nice.
So that whenever people pop through it, it will blow up.
You have that spell?
I do.
I like that spell.
It's a cool spell.
Yeah. And you're casting the... So there's different versions of Glyph of Warding. You're casting the damage one?
Yes, the damage one.
Okay.
I guess it'd be, what, 5d8? You know what? My thing is poison, so... Actually, you know what? It can only do acid, cold, fire, lightning, or thunder. I will do acid damage.
Okay, perfect. It's a rough one, I think.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Okay, so you guys crawl through the vents. It is, like, especially Aunt Tarla, you can, like, barely fit, especially with that badonkadonk.
Mm-hmm.
Mm. The rest of you guys are, you know, crawling. It's a bit slow going, because Aunt Tarla's leading the way. I don't know why that
I
was the
will
choice, but
behind
I'm not
Aunt Tarla.
That slow. I'm thick, but I'm not slow.
Since I'm behind Aunt Tarla, I'll go ba-boom, 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 ba-boom every time she shuffles through the vent.
I hope she doesn't rip one, because it's...
That'd be pretty bad, right? Yeah.
Oh, my goodness.
I would... Yeah.
Let's move on.
any type of punishment I can get,
I let you catch up to me, and then I just, like, just kick back with one of my heels, my heeled boots, and just, like, right in your face.
Oh. Yeah.
Terrible. All right. So, it's stinky as the two of you go behind Aunt Tarla, and you guys get to a crossroads. So, you're kind of, like, at this point in the center of the house, and you know... So, you're under the assumption that you're going to the floor below you, which, again, is, like, the magical... like the magical testing floor of the house. You can go either right or left, leading you to the east or west wing. And you guys know the house, so, I mean, this is where you grew up. You know the rooms of interest each way are in my notes somewhere. Here they are. So you can go either left, which will lead you to Sin's room, the library, and then the artificer's workshop. And then if you go to the right, it'll lead you to the three rooms of either the divination room, where you guys go to, like, divination is kind of like trying to see the future or try to use magic to, like, see other areas in the world. The Hall of Ancestors is there, and then also a demon that your family has had enchained for hundreds of years named Celestia is there as well. And you guys kind of use Celestia, you know, if you feel like really just beating the hell out of something, you do it to Celestia, since she's in a circle of magic circle. She can't leave it. If you, like, have questions about the underworld or, like, the demon realms, things like that, that's what you use her for as well.
So myself as Aunt Tarla, am I more afraid of sin, or am I more afraid of this demon?
How do you think Aunt Tarla would treat a demon that she has complete control over that doesn't leave this one little area?
I mean, I think she'd be fine if it were, like, you know, in a magic circle, but, like, which one is more dangerous, more powerful?
You would imagine sin, like, if the two had to fight each other, you would think it would be sin, just seeing the raw power of this gigantic worm creature.
Well, I'm going to say let's head towards sin and let him go and just, like, have him fuck up the invading army.
When Aunt Tarla mentions that, I will say that when I was out in the hallway before the attack, they were in the library, so they could still be there.
More than likely, they are everywhere in the house. I like the idea of setting Sin free on these intruders.
Is Sin known to attack both, like, our family and their family?
Yeah. If you ever got to go and pet Sin, it would be because Lotria was with you. Like, without Lotria, he's a total wild card.
Sounds like a good idea to me.
Let's do it. So I head towards Sin.
All right, so that's to the west side of the estate. So yeah, you guys travel on a little further and keep going down to all the way at the end of the west wing. Sure enough, right across from you is an air duct exit that you could push through and go down to this level of the floor, which is, the one directly below the ballroom.
All right, before I pop out, I look around. What do I see? Is there anyone in there?
Nope. The hallway that you're in looks completely like it did before you went up to the ballroom to start the night.
Can I see Sin in its cage?
Directly across from you is Sin's room. A little bit farther down is the artificer's workshop, and a little bit farther down from that is the entrance to the library. All three doors are closed currently. Although, give me an investigation check.
5.
And that's all you see.
So I will pop out and drop down as quietly as possible.
Sure. Give me a stealth check.
Now, that's something I can do.
All right.
21.
There you go. What about the rest of you yahoos?
I'll drop down. I'll just follow Aunt Tarla.
Okay.
Do I need to make a stealth check?
Yes, please. I need you to make a stealth check.
21.
All righty. And?
So do I know that Sin is in a cage in its room, or if I open the door to his room, he just gets out?
He is typically in a magical barrier. So, like, half the room is just, like, magic going, like, electricity going up and down, and the other half is where you can walk into. These are big rooms. Again, you guys live in a mansion.
Okay. So I will move towards its room and, you know, being very careful, being very cautious, looking around, I will open the door and enter it.
Okay.
So is this the door to his cage?
To the room.
Yeah, to the room where his cage is.
Okay. So if I stay up in the air duct, I can't see him when he goes into the other room.
You mean her?
I can't see her when she goes into the room. I can't see her anymore.
I guess that's up to you. Like, they've already gone down and crossed the hallway. Like, are you still, like, way back far in the air duct, or are you following close behind?
Really? I feel like after we lent Sin out, then, like, we're going to get back in the air duct.
I think that'd be a good idea. Let him out, get back in the air duct, let out that demon, get back in the air duct.
The demon's on the other side of the...
We didn't have to go the other way.
Oh, so we're going to get Sin out, and then we're going to let the demon out. Okay.
It's my thoughts.
Gee, it'd be real nice if we had someone with Mage Hand to maybe pull the lock. Aunt Tarla, you got that ability?
Nope.
Oh, fuck me. I think I do. I'll just start waving my hand in the air.
Shh. I will shush you.
Shh.
You got all shushed. Right.
I am not... Talena is not very stealthy. I will keep my head in the air duct looking down upon them, and I will be listening very, very key if they need any help from the matron Talena.
Okay, so you're staying up there. All right, so
I'll have a conversation with, once we get out of ear distance,
okay,
and I'll talk to Aunt Tarla.
Mm-hmm.
And I'll say, Aunt Tarla, I don't know about this 10. You know, you can slap me if you want, but she is she's not acting like a matron. She's not acting like she is powerful. You know, we're going to need this for our family. We're fucked right now. We need that strength. And she's up there hiding in a fucking vent right now. Maybe you should be leading this family.
I see your concern, but right now, I think we'll be lucky if we all do not die after this night.
I'll cut myself. Cutting yourself is bad, folks. Yes, don't do it.
We do not condone it.
But I will cut myself for saying that.
There's always help.
So,
everyone, there's always help.
So yeah, I'm going to open that door and get into that room. Do I see anything like of concern? Are there troops? Are there soldiers? Are the bad guys?
Yeah, give me one more investigation check before you go in.
19.
Before you actually open the door, you stop and notice that there is like blood coming through the bottom of the door.
I'll slide a hand the door slightly open to, I guess, try and make no sound and peek inside so that we can see what's going on.
Yeah, go ahead and do
that. Yeah, actually, as I see the blood, I would tell my nephew to open the door for sure. Like, this is all on you, kid.
It's okay. Don't worry. I rolled an 8, but it's a 25.
Cripes.
That's so good.
So you look in there. Sin's cage is down. It looks like these morons didn't know what they were doing. They open the cage, and there are 4 corpses at the moment. Sin, again, this massive... He looks kind of like he's from Tremors. Did you guys see? Like, the opening to him is just like a maw that opens out. He's gorging himself on one of these corpses.
So he's eating it actively right now.
Yes. And then there are 3 others like piled up around him.
I'll whisper to Aunt Tarla and say, hey, Sin, he's out. He's free. What do we want to do? We want to leave this door open?
Well, let's leave that door open and get the heck out of here.
All right. I'll push the door open so that Sin doesn't have to worry about opening it, and we'll head back to the vent.
All right, one more sleight of hand check to see if he notices while he's eating.
I rolled a 3. Plus 17 is 20.
He rolled a 3. So yeah, he's just so...
God. So good.
He's just so enwrapped in like eating dark elf corpse that he's totally cool with whatever's going on around him.
Well, yeah, we hop back in the vent. And now I guess we'd be... Do we want to go further and check out where this branch goes, or do we want to try to let that demon go?
So we could go to the demon room, right? Because that was the other direction that we could have gone?
Right. So the other 2 rooms here on this in this wing are the library and the artificer's workshop. Or, right, you could go back into the vent where the new matron mother is currently, and go talk to Celestia or the Hall of Ancestors or the Divination Room.
Wait, do we have to get to the vent to get to the library, or are we just...
You're in the same ring, wing as the library right now.
Okay,
so... Do you want to keep investigating?
Well, the thing about the library is I would like to look up this family. Would there be a book in the library about this family?
Do a check on that. Give me just straight intelligence.
It's my only negative. 7.
You're not quite sure.
Would you mention this to us, too? Because
yeah, I'd be like,
if anyone's going to spend more time in the library than you, it'd be me.
Are we in the vent, I guess, or are we still in the hall?
We're by the vent, I think. Okay. So, I think we've left the door and we're back by the vent trying to figure out what we're doing.
I would say, hey, if you're ready to come down, I think we're heading to the library. If you want to join us.
Can we get to the library in the vent? Or
no.
Or do we need to walk there?
You would need to walk down the hall.
Okay. I have levitate, so I will jump down. I will levitate down to the floor. And
what is making you levitate so much?
It's a pact. I can freely cast. I'll read it to you if you want. It's an Eldritch invocation, and it's... No, it's not an Eldritch invocation, sir.
Get your character straight. You're a freaking high mother now. High matron.
Yeah, Aunt Tarla. I meant what I said.
I'm just kidding, Robbie.
It is an Eldritch invocation. It's called Ancestral Step.
Okay.
And you can levitate. Cast Levitate on yourself at will without expending a spell slot.
Damn.
Or okay. Material components.
Okay, cool. Just for the listeners and for my
Yeah, I just like the fact that I can levitate anywhere. I think it's pretty intimidating having someone levitate all the time.
Yeah,
it's
cool. I agree. Yeah, definitely. Give me a stealth check with advantage, Robbie, as you come down. I can't imagine that you would screw this up, so I'm going to give you advantage, but just okay. To make sure.
17.
Okay. Yeah, you make it down and float down safely, and you're going to have to pass the Artificer's Workshop to get to the library.
What is the Artificer's Workshop? Is that potions?
No, that is more of like the creation of magical weaponry and things like that. Like enchanting things and making high quality elven, dark elf weapons. Dark elves are known for like the best weapons of all of the races.
Can we, I feel like I'd be familiar with this room.
Oh,
yes, with the weaponry.
Definitely.
Can I listen to see if I hear anything out of the ordinary in there?
Yeah, definitely. As you walk by it, or are you going to like stop and like
I'm
going to
stop and listen.
Okay.
Do a perception, I guess.
Yeah.
Or... 6.
Sounds just like normal.
Sounds okay. I don't hear anything.
Yeah, I don't feel like I need any like weapons or equipment or anything at this moment. I want to learn a bit about this family while we're in this wing.
Sure.
Yeah, this is the one thing that Talena wanted to do is discover the family name that is attacking us. So I feel that going to the library, if it's a possibility of finding that family, I feel that finding the name of the attacking family is a priority, which I say to you guys telepathically to your minds.
I will pretend like I'm going to touch the door in a childish way, like point to it like, okay, fuck it. Let's go to the library.
I pull him by his hair behind us.
Pull hard there.
Oh, God.
I would whisper that, by the way. So. Pull hard there.
So you guys, you leave open Sin's door. You skip past the Artificer's Workshop, and you head into the library. But a library is close to the stairwell, which is just on the other side of the library. Go ahead and just give me one group stealth check.
You have advantage on stealth, Chuck, because I gave you that blessing earlier.
Oh, okay.
Right, it hasn't been more than an hour, right?
No. Probably like 45 minutes, I'd say.
So, man, it's not part of the spell, but if I'm still levitating, do you think I would have advantage?
Yeah, I'll give you advantage since you're not making sound when you hit the ground.
I got a 25.
30?
16.
All right, so you guys are able to make it into the library.
16.
We are so quiet.
Yes, you guys are stealthy.
I love it.
Yeah. So you guys enter the library. Library is a room, I don't know, who of you would probably be most familiar with it?
Not me.
I don't think Ildan can even read.
My name's Ildan.
I don't care what your real name is.
I mean, Tarla's just not around enough. I mean, she definitely would have spent some time here a long time ago, but not recently.
I would be in here reading just to make myself closer to Loth and become... The more knowledge I feel that I have, I can be a better high priest. Mm-hmm. But I would not be in here reading about other families because one of the things that I believe in myself is that I don't feel that families of the past that have been destroyed, I don't think we should mention their family, those names anymore, because once they're gone, they are gone and we should not say their names anymore. So I would not be researching other families. I would be researching about being a high priest and having powerful spells and things like that.
Sure. Well, you guys walk into the library. It doesn't really seem like anything is out of place. It seems like they've kind of left this room as is. All right, so we're looking for a certain book based on prior families.
A History of Families in the Underdark, written by Matt Popich.
Yeah.
I mean, like, libraries definitely were a place that just records are held.
Yeah.
Like, there's got to be some sort of records book.
Sure. Let's get an investigation check from everybody. I assume all of you are working on this.
Yep. I'll do what I'm told.
I maybe would help Matron Mother and give her advantage.
I rolled a 14.
Talena and Tarla together, their teamwork has got them an investigation of 18.
All righty. So you guys work together. You get to the section of the library. And again, we're talking about rows and rows of books. This is not, you guys are in a mansion. These are books, some of them more expensive than others, but definitely like a collector would love to get their hands on some areas of this. You find the area of the library with books of history of the Underdark. It's more focused on Minzo Berenzin and how, like, who conquered who and things like that. At that point, right when you find the correct book, so we can go ahead and roll for initiative.
Uh-oh.
Talena got a 15.
Man, I have advantage on initiative, and I got a 6.
5. I rolled a 1.
What?
Plus 4.
That's your dexterity?
I rolled a 1 plus 4 on my initiative.
Wow. That's pretty terrible.
I rolled a 2 and a 3.
Wow.
Yeah.
What do you mean it's terrible? It's my initiative. What?
I feel like rogues are supposed to have higher than that. I don't know.
Yeah, it's dex base. I've only got 19 points into dex. That's as high as I could go. Plus 4. When you roll a 1, it's pretty rough.
All right.
So with my rapier of warning, I do have... we can't be surprised.
Okay, so So you're right when you start going toward that side of the bookshelves in this big library, your rapier starts rattling a little bit. And then what does it do when it actually is alerting you?
So the guard on it is... The guard of my rapier is a bunch of spider legs, like 8 spider legs, like wrapped around the handle and everything. They start like chittering.
Okay. Yeah. So you start feeling that. Then all of a sudden... The books just erupt from all around you as an animate object spell has been cast on all the books. So you are attacking a swarm of books all that is coming flying in your direction.
That's exciting.
I thought so.
I hate books. I want to stab them.
Books
are dumb. Reading is dumb. Literacy is bad.
Man, Nazi Germany over here. What is going on with you?
No, my wife actually teaches.
Oh, right.
I'm just kidding.
That'll show her.
Yeah, that'll show her.
Take that, professions.
Books.
Yeah.
So I assume, Matt, that this is the attacking family that casted this on these books?
I'd say that's a pretty safe assumption, yeah. Your own family wouldn't have done that, yeah. All right, so they actually rolled the highest, and we're going to go ahead. I'm going to have 2 fly at Aunt Tarla, 12 to hit, 27 to hit.
The 27 does not... I'm just kidding. Yeah, the 27 totally hits. My AC is 18.
7 damage. 21 against the new matron and a crit against...
Oh, me?
What does it look like when the books attack? Are they just like literally just punching us in the face?
Yeah, so like all of a sudden they just flew out of nowhere from all the shelves all around you. The one that hits Chuck hits him like square between the eyes because he got crit on, and it just like drops to the floor afterwards. But they flew out, but they're gonna, after they hit you, they kind of like fly away and flutter as they, like kind of like a bird. Chuck, take 9 damage.
I'll use uncanny dodge.
Okay.
To take half.
Okay.
The damage.
And then Robbie takes 7 damage.
What is half of 9? Is it going to be 5? Is that right?
Round up. Yep. After that is Robbie.
So I got hit by a book?
You got hit by a book, sir.
Can you describe what happened when I got hit by that book?
You were about to grab the proper book that you think it would have the answers, and you got just like slammed in the back of the head, basically.
I get slammed in the back of the head, and then when I tip my head back forward, you guys notice that my nose is bloody because I am below at half HP.
Wow. This is our first combat.
I got hit by a fiery blast of some kind of trap. How many books are we actually talking about around here?
4 just hit you.
Yeah, right? Got an area of effect? Matron?
Fireball.
I'm a warlock. I don't have fireball.
You're just going to light up your own library? I mean, do whatever. I don't care.
That's a dex save, right? I think I'll be all right.
Yeah, you guys are all pretty close to each other at this point.
My dex save was only plus 3, but you do whatever you want, Matron Mother. It's your world. We just live in it.
I will pull out my wand of magic missile, and I will cast it at level 5 to hit each book with 2 charges. The dart deals 1d4.
Okay.
Plus 1.
Plus 1. So
they don't miss.
Right. This will be the book that hit me in the back of the head, I guess.
Mm-hmm.
6.
Okay.
And then the next closest one, 7.
Okay.
5 for the next one.
Okay.
9 damage for the last one.
Ooh, good hit. Yeah, they kind of all get hit and then like shudder a little bit, but then they keep flying around. Next is, due to your poor guys' rolling, so Tarla, who was near a bookshelf trying to help, all of a sudden the bookshelf just kind of like falls on top of her.
What?
Yeah, it was animated too.
Gotcha.
sucker.
It will be 17 to hit.
Does not hit.
Oh, so you kind of see it like falling and like starting to lean over, and you like jump out of the way real quick.
Nice.
Yeah, that was good. I thought I'd get you on that one. Aunt Tarla is then up.
Wait, do I need to attack this actual bookshelf itself?
So it fell, but with an obvious attempt, like it like basically stood up and then lurched forward on top of you. It hasn't yet stood up or anything like that, but it definitely stood up the first time, so.
Well, I'll just swing my sword at some of these books, I guess.
Sure.
Got a 21 to hit.
Yeah, I got it.
So I am going to do 7 piercing damage and 4 poison damage.
Not so sure I can buy the poison damage.
Yeah, I know. I assume the poison would not work.
Okay. So 7 damage to the one that's closest to you.
Yep, I just try to skewer one of the books.
You got it.
Did I skewer it a bit?
You did. You kind of knocked it off its current flight path, but it's still flying around.
Jeez.
I know. They have 20 HP each. They started that much, so we're kind of nickel and diming them down. Mm-hmm. Here's someone that doesn't nickel and dime. What do you got there, Mr. Assassin?
Is the only book near me the one that fell on the ground?
Yeah, that one fell on the ground after the crit.
I'll make sure it's dead, I guess. And
okay.
I'll pull my short sword blade out and just do a little flourish with it, and I'll say, yippee-ki-yay, let's get to it. And I'll stab it on the ground.
I'm surprised the yippee-ki-yay, like I figured it would be used at some point, obviously. But yeah. On a book, I guess I'm surprised.
Yeah, I thought so too. I'm like, man, that's a burn of a line
fuck
there.
It. 16.
That, sir. Go ahead and roll with advantage because that's a miss, but it was on the ground.
18.
That's a hit.
16 on a book is a miss?
They're flying
that's
around.
On the ground?
Well, that's why I gave you advantage.
I guess if I have advantage, it's a crit there. It's a sneak attack then, so. Oh, shit.
Yeah, as long as it's more than 13, you kill it.
21.
It's dead. That's fine.
27 damage.
So this mean old book hits you in the face and falls to the ground, and you pull out your dagger and stab the shit out of it and yell yippee-ki-yay.
That's right.
Okay.
And I'll move towards Aunt Tarla to assist her, I guess.
Okay. 3 books left as we go to the top of the order here. They'll fly one at each of you. Aunt Tarla.
Oh, shit.
10 to hit. 20 to hit. Ildan. 15 to hit. Matron Mother, 10.
Hit. I get hit
is
by
it
15.
Too late to say I use my bonus action to dodge, but whatever. It's fine.
What does that do?
I can just use my bonus action to dodge. So
which is I have disadvantage.
Impose disadvantage.
It means you have a disadvantage on me.
Yeah, I want to do something too.
All right. Then I'm going to say neither of you can do shit because this is getting ridiculous.
Good. That's good.
Yeah, good.
Let it hit me. It's fine. Good. I'll use uncanny dodge.
All right.
Good. I like aggressive bet.
7 damage, Chuck. 5 damage, Robbie. Robbie, you're up.
3 books left, you said?
3 books left and a bookshelf.
Eldritch Blast is one of the books.
Sure.
So if I can create 2 beams of my Eldritch Blast, could I aim them at 2 different things?
Yes, you can.
All right. Well, I want to see if I hit one first. The one that hit me. 17.
Miss.
Okay, I will
these
try.
These books. Man, you got to hit them books
are everywhere. They're flying all around, man.
I will try to hit the one that hit me again.
It's like trying to hit a mosquito.
18.
There you go. That's it.
Weasel. 10 damage.
Okay. So it is barely fluttering, but it is alive.
All right. That's my turn.
All righty. The bookshelf will stand itself up and try to like flop on Matron Mother. 15.
So is it against my AC?
It is.
I'm going to use my reaction.
Sounds like someone's scared they're going to die. This might be a 3-episode campaign, y'all.
Might be done. A new Matron Mother.
Death by books.
Yay.
Oh, shit.
Once per short rest, when a creature makes an attack roll against you, you can use a reaction to impose disadvantage on that roll. If it misses, your next attack roll against that creature will have advantage. So
cool.
Disadvantage roll.
So I'm rolling again.
Yep.
It was even better. This is 21.
I attempted to dodge it, and I still get crushed by this book.
It's really big, yeah.
Oh, my goodness.
It's a big book.
12 damage.
Don't you look over here, punk.
I didn't. That was Chuck, so that everyone knows it wasn't me. Oh. I don't do that.
Chuck's a peeper.
Chuck is a peeper.
Ooh. Hey, nothing wrong with that, yeah.
Casey.
So, I am... Honestly, all of my spells are like... utility spells. So I'm flipping through everything here. I don't see anything terribly helpful. But how many books? So we have this bookshelf and how many books left?
3 books. One of them looks just beat to hell. Like it looks like it's barely flopping around. And then you have this bookshelf.
Can I catch all of them in fairy fire? It's a 20-foot radius.
Yeah, they're flying around, but they are flying around pretty close to you.
So I will highlight all of these creatures. They all need to make a dexterity saving throw.
Sure. And the book case?
Yep.
Okay. All right, the book face crit missed. Oh, wow, they have plus four dex, believe it or not. What is my save?
15 is my
all right, DC. Only one of them passed. The other has failed.
So all of the others are marked with fairy fire. There's like a light purpley fire on their form, and everyone has advantage on attacks against them.
Oh, wow.
As a bonus action, cast a mass healing word.
There you go.
You know what? I'm going to cast it at the fourth level.
Wow, healing that matron mom up.
Yeah, so I'm worried about my mama, my new mama. So we all get...
Who's younger than you? Your niece.
My niece.
Yeah.
There we go. That's a double four. So that's 11. Everyone gets 11 hit points back, all three of us. I say, Loth won't give us more than we can bear, and all of us gain 11 hit points.
A lot of faith in that demon goddess, don't you?
Yeah, I do. Yeah, sure. That's where that healing power came from.
There you go. This is true. So everybody has advantage on your attacks. Chuck, you're up.
The book that's the closest book to Aunt Tarla, I will attack with my short sword.
You helping out Aunt Tarla?
Well, I just want to... I'm near her, I guess. Sure. Whatever you want to say, man. Yeah. I guess I have advantage.
You
correct?
Do. Yeah.
22.
That'll hit.
32 damage.
Yeah. It only had 20 to start with, so dead big time.
And I'll use my bonus action to dodge.
Cool. So two left, and they will swing at the ladies. Woo! Crit on Matron Mom.
All right, I'm sorry. I want to correct that because I made a mistake. So,
sure, let's just keep.
I guess I can't use a.
Just kidding.
Hold on. I just want to make sure we're playing by the rules here.
Okay.
I feel like I can use my action to dodge, but my bonus action to dodge, but
look up cunning action. That's the name of the skill.
Yeah,
you're trying to use.
That's the thing. Yeah. The only thing I saw. That's why I wanted to correct it was dash, disengage, or hide.
Dodge. I was really surprised.
If I'm near anything, any books, I will disengage.
Okay.
And bounce away.
Okay, so. Sounds good. Robbie, 14 against AC?
Matches. I thought you said crit.
Yeah, it was crit against you. Sorry, you're right. Casey, 14 to AC?
Miss.
Okay. 12 damage, Robbie.
All right, I'm going to Hellish Rebuke that attack.
Oh, no.
I'm fucking pissed.
You've had enough.
Hellish Rebuke, point your finger, and the creature that damaged you is moderately surrounded by hellish flames. The creature must make a dexterity saving throw. It takes this amount of fire damage on a failed save or half as much as a successful one.
Go for
it. Dexterity saving throw by you. Beat an 18.
I did not.
Burning books, man.
I know, right?
It's a 6d10. Do I need to roll that shit?
No, he's only at 7 life. You already hit him once.
Oh, man, that was overkill.
Yeah, that's why I was like, oh.
Overkill, master.
Yeah, indeed. There's one book left and then the bookshelf. Actually, it's your turn, Robbie.
Okay, I will Eldritch Blast the one book. And that's going to miss. I will Eldritch Blast it. Oh, wait, I have advantage.
Yep, you do.
I think that's a 26, but let me double check.
All right. He only has one HP left, so.
He rolled a 16. It's got to
right,
hit.
It's fine, yeah. All right. You absolutely roast it. The blast just goes right through. What does your Eldritch Blast look like? That's important.
Spider webs.
Yeah, Spider-Man.
So it's a beam that's brightly purple and a mix of blue, and the center is yellow, like a lightning bolt that has the radiant light coming off of it is purple and blue. And it looks like a lightning bolt coming from, it would just come out of my finger.
Okay. Yeah, it just goes right through this book that, one of them just gets lit up in flames, absolutely destroyed, and another, you turn around and like zap it, and it just flops to the ground, burning.
My next Eldritch Blast, I will hit the bookcase.
It only has 10 AC. It's monstrous.
I hit it.
I figured.
11 damage.
Alrighty.
And is this thing, I assume, is it close to me?
It is, yeah. In fact, it's going to get up. It's going to do like a... So it's flat on the ground right now. It's going to like flip up and try and land on you.
Is it its turn right now?
Yep, it is. 21?
Yes.
Oh, I think someone's about
16
to...
damage.
I'm fucking dead.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
Dude, I didn't know like fighting these books in a bookcase would be this tough. I could have casted some really high powerful spells, but it's a book in a bookshelf. I assume they had like one HP each.
Animate object. Look it up, folks.
As soon as that happens, I would say, oh shit, should have stayed in school, man.
should have fireballed.
The question is Aunt Tarla going to heal you? We'll find out soon. Matron Mother shoots the rays, kills a book, shoots another at the big, gigantic bookshelf, and the bookshelf flips up and just like slams down on her, and she is completely covered at this point by the bookshelf. Aunt Tarla, you're up.
All right, so how many things are left for me to attack? The bookshelf and
the bookshelf that is smothering your niece.
This is embarrassing. I died to a bookshelf. You did. It's so embarrassing.
I'm going to assume, here's the thing, is like all my damage stuff is like necrotic or poison. So I will just, I guess, holding my rapier with two hands, just start chopping down on it, hacking at the wood.
Yeah, go for it. It's only 10 AC, so.
I mean, 18.
You'd have to like slip and fall to not hit it, so.
There we go. 10 damage and 8 poison damage.
Nice. So yeah, you give it a good whack and chip off some of the outside of one of the panels. Chuck, you're up.
I will do the same thing.
Good move.
And hack at it.
Yes.
Advantage.
Hit with advantage.
14.
Yeah, that's a hit. All right.
Oh, 14's a hit. Okay.
Yeah.
23 damage.
Nice. Oh yeah, you take like a huge chunk of panel out of this thing. Like it's kind of like half of a bookshelf, but it is still up and moving here.
Yeah, and I'll disengage away from the bookshelf.
All right, top of the order. Robbie, go ahead and make your first death saving throw.
This goes to show everyone that libraries are very dangerous. I failed.
Two.
Oh, boy. All right, there's one death save. this will be the bookshelf. It is going to flip up the rogue disengage. So, Aunt Tarla, it's going to kind of like make a side, like it'll stand up and then like flop sideways on top of you.
Okay, yeah, I'm gonna raise my shield and just like brace for it and protect the matron mother so it doesn't smash us both.
It rolled a 21.
That's gonna hit me.
16 damage.
I can take it.
Does that hit him too?
No, they were okay. On opposite sides of each other. Okay. And it's your turn, new matron Tarla.
All right, so I will, as it's falling on me, and my shield was not enough to block it, and I will just, I guess, grab my sword and swing it up at it.
Mm-hmm.
There's a crit.
Hey.
A crit sandwich.
Sandwich it.
Yeah, let's see if
nom,
it's a
nom,
sandwich.
Nom, nom.
That's a sandwich.
Hey! Do it.
All right, so more, I can roll again. 20 yeah. Now.
Keep going one? On that.
Oh, there was a 19 in there.
Dang it.
So, but I get 2d8 plus the poison damage, which I assume the poison damage doesn't do anything, right?
I'm giving you half.
Okay. All right. Well, I'll keep that poison damage
fun.
Up. That is 12 piercing damage and 6 poison damage.
All right. So you fly into an absolute rage, just slashing and kicking this thing and destroy all of its panels until it's literally just nothing but former books and panels of broken wood on the ground, and you feel like there's not much more that this thing could do to you, and we are out of initiative.
I will stand over the body of Matron Talena, and I'm gonna think long and hard. I'm gonna stare down at her as she's partially unconscious, breathe in deeply, sigh.
Before you cast a spell, I will say something to you.
Sure.
Aunt Tarla, she's not gonna wake up. It's you and me now, right? She's weak. This is our chance. You rule. You're the new matron. I'll follow you. She got killed by a bookshelf. I'll start chuckling as I say it. She got killed by a bookshelf. You know, our family's already weak, but if that gets out... Fuck. We're in even worse shape. But you don't have to do this. We can also find out in episode 3 of Crit Sandwich.
You know, guys, I thought we were bad at D&D for a minute, but I think we're good.
We would not tell anybody about this, okay? Do not tell anybody I got killed by a bookshelf.
Do you want to let it? Do you want to?
I think that's a good ending. Right. I think that's a good ending.
Let's do it. I'm in.
Hey! I think that's the first time.
Bookshelf.
I think that's the first time a player has ended an episode instead of the DM. Thanks for sinking your teeth into Crit Sandwich. Please give us a review on iTunes or the Apple Podcast app. Please follow us on Twitter, Facebook, or email us at critsandwichpodcast@gmail.com.